வெல்கம் டு ஏடிஎம் காலேஜ் ஃபார் விமன் நாகப்பட்டினம். ஐ எம் மிஸ்ஸஸ் எஸ் ராஜேஸ்வரி, அசோசியேட் ப்ரொஃபஸர் ஆஃப் எக்கனாமிக்ஸ். டுடே ஐ வில் எக்ஸ்பிளைன் அபவுட் த மேஜர் டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் பிட்வீன் இன்டர்னல் அண்ட் இன்டர்நேஷ்னல் ட்ரேட். பிஃபோர் தட், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வி ஷுட் நோ த மீனிங் ஃபார் இன்டர்னல் ட்ரேட். சி, இன்டர்னல் ட்ரேட் இட் இஸ் நத்திங் பட் த எக்ஸ்சேஞ்ச் ஆஃப் குட்ஸ் அண்ட் சர்வீசஸ் வித்தின் த கண்ட்ரி ஆர் வித்தின் நேஷ்னல் பார்டர். In the case of international trade, it means there is exchange of goods and services between the countries or across the national border. This is the first difference. Next one, in an international trade, there is only one country is involved, whereas international trader, two or more countries involved. The next difference is all firms have the same pattern of interest, inflation and tax system, whereas in the case of international trade, there are different interest rate, inflation and tax rate in different countries. Next, in internal trade, it increases the employment and improves specialization within the countries, that is within home countries or regional countries. Whereas international trade, it helps to improve international specialization. It causes rise in global employment. And another difference, the transactions are settled in the domestic currency. And international trade, it leads to the payments have to be made in the currency of exporter or acceptable some foreign currency. Another difference, there are no restriction in case of domestic trade. No restrictions means that is obstacle, that is like that tariff quota, anything. Okay. Next, international trade, the countries can impose restrictions in case of international trade. Next, we will move on the another slide. There are no trade barriers in case of internal trade. In international trade, there are many countries imposes tariffs and non-tariff barriers, both countries, that is importing and exporting countries. See, tariffs, it is nothing but custom duties levied upon imports and exports. See, next difference, mobility of factors of production. See, factors of production, that is land, labor, capital and organization, it is mobile within the country. But in case of international trade, the factors of production are immobile. It is compared to less. Another point or another difference, the market size is smaller. So growth opportunities are also very limited. In international trade, the market size is very large. So, and therefore, the growth potential also very high. Next one, in internal trade, the buyer and the seller are located in the same country. So, they have to follow the rules and regulations of home countries. In international trade, the importer and the exporter are located in different countries. So, they have to follow the rules and regulations of both countries. Another one, risk are involved comparatively less in internal trade. That is because it involves only within the countries. The trade involves only within the country. Whereas the international trade, risk involved are comparatively more. And next one, transportation costs are lesser because goods are transported over short distances. Whereas in international trade, the transportation costs are more because goods are transported over long distance. Next one, next difference, time involved in transportation and the possibility of spoilage is less in internal trade. In international trade, transportation time and the possibility of spoilage is very more. And another one, the modes of transport. See, the major modes of transport are by roadways or railways for the internal trade. In international trade, the mode of transport is sea or air. So, transportation generally happens through sea or air. And another important point, it improves social and economic welfare of the country. But in international trade, it improves social and economic welfare of the trading countries only. And next, the procedures and documentations involved are lesser in the internal trade, whereas in case of international trade, the procedures to be followed and documentation is more and complex. See, these are all the difference between internal and international trade. Next, what are the importance of international trade, or why do nations enter into trade? The main reasons for this, the resources are within the country not be sufficient to satisfy the wants of citizen, so they import the scarce items from other countries. Another one, labor availability and human skill differ from one country to another country. Like that, the entrepreneurial attitude, skills and facility available differ from one country to another country. See, factors of production are immobile among the countries. Another important point, the technological development differ from one country to another country. So all the countries do not have same type and extent of resources. So in case of the resources is differ from one country to another country. And next one, many barriers to international trade, that is development of communication technology, transportation network. See, the development of transportation network have increased the flow of goods between the nations, that is between two countries. Next one, that is domestic market, money market may not be large. It helps to expand production, sales and profits. So the important basis of international trade is difference in cost of goods in different countries. Therefore, goods can be imported from those countries where costs are cheaper. Thank you.